Today we're going to continue our discussion about unemployment. We're going to talk about one of my favorite days of the month. Usually on a Thursday night, I can't get to sleep in anticipation for this Friday. One of my favorite days of the month is Jobs Friday. Jobs Friday is the first Friday of every month. It's when the Bureau of Labor Statistics announces the unemployment rate for the previous month.
It's Jobs Day, giving us a look at it.
The BLS is responsible for making sure the unemployment rate is accurately reported, reported consistently, and reported frequently. Understanding what happens in labor markets allows us to have a better idea of what's happening in the overall economy. The question we have today is, how does the BLS calculate the unemployment rate? During the month, the BLS samples 60,000 households in 2,000 different geographic regions. These households have 110,000 individuals. Every month, the BLS replaces a quarter of the households, and no household can be in the data more than 4 consecutive months. Based on the answers of the survey, the BLS estimates the total number of people unemployed in the US and what the unemployment rate is. Using this information, the BLS calculates several measures of unemployment. The most popular one that is usually tracked and reported in the news is the U3 unemployment rate. But economists actually track several measures of unemployment.
And that's how the unemployment data is collected. The BLS uses this data to separate people into different categories.
Let us take a look at how the labor market looks in the US. The total US population is roughly 330 million people. The first important definition is working age population. The working age population includes civilians above the age of 16 that are non-institutionalized. The military is excluded from unemployment and labor force calculations. That group is then split into two different categories, the labor force and not in the labor force. Not in the labor force is defined as students, homemakers, retirees, discouraged workers. The labor force, on the other hand, is then split into two other categories, those employed and those unemployed. Remember, the definition of unemployed means individuals that are actively seeking a job in the past 4 weeks. Using this information, we can then calculate the unemployment rate by dividing the number of unemployed by the labor force and multiplying it by 100. And that's how we calculate the U3 unemployment rate. Looking at the 30-year graph of the U3 unemployment rate, looks like this. The U3 unemployment rate is popular and it is usually the one that is referenced in the news.
After 2 months of unprecedented increases, US unemployment rate took a surprising turn in May. It went down. This dip was a hopeful sign that the economy might be bouncing back from coronavirus lockdowns. But that dip wasn't universal. Black unemployment ticked upwards. It declined in June, but not at the same rate as unemployment overall. This follows a decade where the unemployment gap between white and black workers has been narrowing. But the recent unemployment figures reveal...
There are other unemployment rates that we also keep track of. The BLS reports the U1 through U6 every month, and each of these measures helps us learn more about the different segments of the labor market. Another measure that the BLS provides is the labor force participation rate. It measures the labor force as a fraction of working age population. Remember, the labor force is equal to the number of people employed plus those seeking jobs. The labor force participation rate provides us with another measure of strength of the labor market. The past 30 years of data show that the labor force participation rate hovers around 63%. During recessions, the labor force participation rate falls as more people exit the labor market and shift towards education or other activities. The labor force participation rate is also sensitive to the population pyramid. In countries where the population is aging, the labor force participation rate will be lower. As people retire, they tend to exit the labor force. When we talk about the strength of the labor market, it is important to know which number to follow and what those numbers actually calculate. The BLS provides an important service by making this information available consistently to us. We learned how the BLS collects unemployment data, the different labor market categories, and how to calculate the unemployment rate and the labor force participation rate.
Now you know more about unemployment. More importantly, you know about my favorite day of the month, Jobs Friday. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, comment. Tell me what you're thinking.